Alex Caruso is a great clutch role player in the NBA, meaning 5 minutes left and the score is within 5 points. Who has worked and worked a claw's way to the top? But his particular skill is that of a cerebral defender, as he has a very good basketball IQ, and his plans help him to use his surprising strength and quick lateral movement to fantastic effect. But there's more to Caruso than just playing basketball. So let's jump in and find out a little more about the recent new addition to the Chicago Bulls lineup. Don't miss out as we look into Alex Caruso, his lifestyle, and net worth. Early life. So first, let's have a recap of the career of the Bald Mamba himself. Born on February 28, 1994 in College Station, Texas, Alex Michael Caruso is one of three children of parents Mike and Jackie Caruso, with sisters Megan and Emily. Caruso attended the Agricultural and Mechanical, or A&M, Consolidated High School between 2012 and 2016 in his home region, where he played basketball under head coaches Rusty Siegler and Rick German. When he was a senior in the school playing for the basketball team, he averaged 18 points and 9 rebounds and was named the Texas Association of Basketball Coaches All-Regional, All-State, as well as TABC All-Star, and also the district MVP after leading his team for the year and into the postseason. Once he had graduated from high school, he was among the ESPN top 100 recruits and, via a scholarship, joined the Texas A&M Aggies, a local men's basketball team that represents Texas A&M University in the NCAA Division I college ball in the Southeastern Conference. And during his time with the team, he played in 137 games and averaged 8 points, 4.7 assists, and 2.02 steals per game. He finished as the school's all-time leader in assists with an impressive 649 and steals with 276. And as a senior, he led the Aggies to the Sweet 16 of the NCAA tournament, earning SEC All-Defensive Team and second-team All-SEC honors in the process. Cracking into the NBA. In 2016, Caruso was undrafted during the 2016 NBA draft, which is always a setback, but like most undrafted players, he then had to work harder and prove that he deserved a spot in the league. So he joined the Philadelphia 76ers for the NBA Summer League of that year. On September 23rd, he signed with the Oklahoma City Thunder, but he was later waived by the team in October. Finally, in November 2016, he was acquired by the Oklahoma City Blue of the NBA Development League. After that, in 2017, he joined the Los Angeles Lakers for the NBA Summer League, where he played productively in several games, particularly in one instance when he started for the team in place of Lonzo Ball, who was injured at the time. Coming off the bench to start for the team in that game, he led the Lakers to a victory and was signed to the Lakers' first two-way contract in July of that year. He certainly knows the value of hard work and, as a result, was the first player ever to go from the G League straight into the NBA via two-way contract. Breaking out. His breakout years began in 2018, when, after an impressive display in the 2018 NBA Summer League, he signed another two-way contract with the Lakers and became the only player for the team in that season, other than LeBron James, to record a 30-point, 10-rebound, 5-assist game. When James was out for the end of the 2019 season, Caruso once scored 18 points with a career-high 11 assists to win a game over the Utah Jazz on April 7, 2019. Caruso would stay with the Lakers for another 2 years, signing a 2-year deal worth $5.5 million, and won his first NBA championship with them on October 11, 2020, when the Lakers defeated the Miami Heat over 6 games. In fact, Caruso started the clinching game of the NBA Finals too, and became an unrestricted free agent after the season ended in 2021. Moving to Chicago. Most recently, in August 2021, Caruso signed a 4-year, $37 million contract to join the Chicago Bulls, where he has made a real impact and proven himself to be worthy of plenty of fans calling him the GOAT. Plenty of folks were trying to work out why he let himself become a free agent and move to another team. But it does seem that there were some strange things happening. The Lakers didn't seem to care about whether they had Alex or not, and were reported to be being aggressive to try and keep Caruso as a free agent. They also reportedly put up very little, if any, fight at all to try and keep him, especially after trying to sign and trade him somewhere else instead of keeping. There were even reports that Caruso was willing to return to the Lakers and take less money than he took from the Bulls, but it wasn't to be. It's strange because he's certainly become one of the most popular players in the sport today, being one of the extremely few NBA stars who has absolutely no haters. Maybe it's because he was an underdog. Maybe it's because he hasn't caused any major scandals. And maybe it's like, unlike former teammate LeBron James, he doesn't divide his audience with politically charged rhetoric. This is interesting because it would be fair to say that Caruso was largely overlooked for much of his career so far, being a detail-oriented all-arounder who gets in the mix to fight for the ball, draws contact where needed, and handles the little things. He's never had any particularly amazing qualities like insane athleticism, nor is he the type to steal the spotlight, but he has absolutely deserved every success he has had. Hard worker. He's proof that hard work does pay off, though, as the 27-year-old is now estimated to have a net worth of around $2 million, which you might think doesn't sound like very much for an NBA star, but when you consider that he was an undrafted player who worked and worked to get where he is now, it's probably about where it should be. His latest $37 million contract with the Chicago Bulls over 4 years includes an annual salary average of $9.25 million. And in the 2021-22 season, Caruso will earn a base salary of $8,604,000, which is undoubtedly his highest salary in his entire NBA career. Caruso's father, Mike, played basketball too, for 4 years at Creighton University, and also went on to become an associate athletic director at Texas A&M University. So it does seem that the game is in Alex's blood, at least to some degree. Romance. As far as his romantic life is concerned, Caruso was, for a long time, dating Abby Brewer, an employee for the Power Group, a small public relations and communications company with only a few employees, as a senior account executive. It does seem that they broke up a while ago, though, but no one can say that Caruso isn't consistent or that he doesn't have a type. He certainly seems to like slim, sexy blonde ladies because his new girlfriend is Mia Amabile, a gorgeous Instagram model who has drawn 263,000 followers to her account with her racy content. Health. As for his fitness, totally key to anyone playing in a professional sport, Caruso commented on his workouts, particularly how he stayed in shape during the 2020 virus situation and having to stay at home in LA, saying that, "I do workouts at home in my garage. It's pretty old school. Just a bunch of bodyweight stuff, some jump rope, and I have a good hill by me that I run up and down. That is old school." He went on to explain that he needed to stay as close to normal as he could, considering that he expected no one to be in the same shape they were in when they disbanded for lockdowns. He says that he eats very healthy at the gym, but he doesn't have a personal chef like some guys on the team. He eats chicken, grilled vegetables, rice pilaf, mashed potatoes, that kind of thing. Whatever he can cook himself, basically. Entertainment. As for entertainment, he mentioned that he likes watching reruns of The Office and playing Xbox games like Call of Duty and Fortnite. He claims that he's a little bit above average, even though he's the humble type. The wrap-up. That seems to be precisely the cause of his success and his status as a beloved player, as Caruso is indeed a humble, down-to-earth and normal kind of guy who hasn't lost touch with the day-to-day of normal life and remembers his roots. People love an underdog, and they also love it when people in positions of high prestige don't act like they own the entire world. Add to that his ability as a player and his gelling well with the Bulls lineup, and it's not hard to see why Alex Caruso only seems to have good things ahead of him.